welcome to This Week in Ames. In today's show, we're going to check in with the water treatment plant. Evans, who is an environmental engineer with the Water and Pollution Control Department, but she's also a project manager with this very impressive project. Chris, welcome to the show.
Thanks, Susan, and welcome to the new water treatment plant.
This is exciting. So much going on and so much progress. This project has been a long time in coming.
It has. We started design of the treatment plant itself probably about 5 years ago. We've been under construction for a little over 2 years, and we're getting ready. Processes are being started up. We're looking at getting equipment going here, and we should actually be functioning yet this summer.
Amazing, really amazing. Tell us a little bit about our existing water treatment plant. It is kind of tucked away downtown.
It is downtown. We're near the power plant. We're near Banshell Park, and it's been there since about 1920, and it has continued to be added onto and added onto. It's nominally going to treat about 11 million gallons a day. It's a lime softening plant. We basically ran out of room. It's an old facility, and we weren't able to bring it up to code. And so council gave us a direction to build a new facility at a new location. So here we are.
Yeah, and that old plant is interesting. As you watch those additions coming online, you start seeing that the plant is divided into multiple levels. There's stairs everywhere. Accessibility really is an issue. You don't have those problems here.
No, not at all. For those who have been on tours of the existing water treatment plant, we do. We have little nooks and crannies, rooms that have been added on to, very, very tight working conditions. Here, when we started design, one, the most important thing was water quality. We wanted to keep that great tasting water that our Ames residents love. But then we did look at how we were going to use this facility for decades to come. The existing water plant's been around for about 100 years. And we really respected that there was a lot of planning went into that. And so we hope to do the same here. We've got a lot of space, but we do have plans to be able to continue treatment and add on so we can use this facility for a long time in the future.
So you mentioned the existing plant, about 11 million gallons per day. What do we have here?
Sure. We've constructed up to 15 million gallons a day, but we've also planned out how we can add an additional 10 million gallons in two stages. So ultimately, we could get 25 million gallons a day here at this facility.
So really a 100-year plan.
We really tried to go into that with that thinking is, hey, what does Ames need for the next 100 years?
Yeah, now you mentioned Ames Great Tasting Water. We're known around this state, the nation, probably
exactly.
Around the world for our great tasting, fabulous water. Now, I understand, same great recipe, same great water source, nothing will change.
Absolutely. We're going to continue to use the wells that we have scattered throughout the community. We're still going to do lime softening. We're still going to filter. We're still going to treat just like we always have, but we just have a newer facility. Nothing's going to change, hopefully.
Very exciting. I understand you even have a mark your calendar date coming up.
We do. Mark your calendars, August 26th. We will have our ribbon cutting and an open house for the public to come see the new facility, look around, see what we've been doing here on the site for the last 2.5 years.
Really, really exciting stuff. How does the water treatment plant staff feel about this?
We're very excited. We've been lucky that the entire staff, from the director, assistant director, engineers, to the water plant superintendent, maintenance workers, the operators, we've all been involved in this. We've had people looking at plans throughout the design process, so they were able to give their input on how they intended to operate things or how they intended to maintain it. And then coming out, they've been very, very involved during construction as well, coming out and looking at things as it progresses, but also helping to be our eyes out here. If things don't look quite right, being able to bring that question up and saying, hey, is this really how we want it?
Well, it looks great to me, and it's so exciting to see this coming from the ground up to this fabulous facility. Can't wait till August 26th.
Great. Well, everyone should come on out and see us the end of August.
Thanks, Chris.
Thanks, Susan.
Again, mark your calendar. That open house is scheduled for Saturday, August 26th. I know it seems like a ways away, but you won't want to miss it. Other things to think about coming up in May. Remember, Memorial Day weekend is the opening of the Furman Aquatic Center. You can get more information about that on our website, cityofames.org. Well, that's our show for today. Thanks for watching, and tune in next week for This Week in Ames.